This is enough wood for 34 pipes, 17 pipes for each of two organs. It does not include the three base pipes. Each of these first seven stacks has enough wood for two pipes of each length. And then these last stacks are enough wood for four pipes. When you get to the higher pitch pipes, a given length of pipe is used for two different notes. This afternoon, I cut the wood for 34 pipes for two senior organs, and I used the baby table saw. That thin curve 4-inch saw blade is very nice. It doesn't waste much wood. This is basswood. They're 3-inch wide sheets, and this is the scrap that was left over after cutting 34 pipes. My recommendation on cutting the pipes is cut the longest ones first and work your way to the smallest pipes. As you start cutting your wood, my basswood was 2-foot long sheets, and you start working your way through the longest pipes, then you'll start having wood that's left over that's long enough to start making some of the shorter pipes. Half of the pipes were made out of 1/8-inch basswood, and then the smaller pipes were made out of 3/32. I suggest the first thing you do is deburr the edges, get all the fuzz and stuff off of there. Especially if you're using this basswood seems to get a little fuzzy from the cut. The smaller pipes are easier. You can clamp up several at one time on this jig. So this is my pipe factory. With the smaller pipes, you can work on either side of this support, and you can do 8 of them at a time. Today I was working on putting 20 of the smallest pipes together to this point. And then tomorrow, that glue will be good and dry. I'll flip them around and finish these pipes and start on the next batch. These don't take a long time to put together. It goes quite fast. If you're square cut, and these are square cut because I use that baby table saw, but if your wood is square cut and you cut these pieces off square, it goes together quite fast. If you use a jig like this, I put some automotive wax on here so that the glue wouldn't stick to this plastic. Four pipes cut and assembled in 3 days. There's still a lot of work to be done to go in here and sand all this and fine-tune everything, but this is a good start. Yesterday I painted the inside surfaces of all the pipes with shellac. That worked out pretty well. It's a very thin product, alcohol base, soaked into the wood, got down into all the corners. It does raise the surface of the wood a little bit. Not nearly as bad as what the varnish did, but still I want to go in and sand the inside a little bit to knock down any of that fuzz. I took some of the scrap sticks from cutting out the pipes and I glued strips of sandpaper on here. On this one, I made a T-bar so it wouldn't flex. Put some sandpaper on that one. I use that on the bigger pipes. When I put the shellac on here, it gets a little sloppy, and I want to make sure that that does not interfere with attaching the covers or the gasket on the front of the pipes. So this is Norton 120. I just put that on a flat surface, and I'm just going to drag that across there a couple of times just to clean that up so I get a good glue joint. Take an emery board, and let's go on the inside surface and on the outside just to round over these edges, so I don't get a splinter and so it doesn't interfere with the plug later on. Now I go on the inside and these flat faces. All I'm doing is removing that little bit of the fuzz or the grain that's been raised by putting the shellac on here. I do not want to sand through the wood. Feels pretty good. I put that stick in there. Make sure it's flat. I just drag that back and forth a couple of times on each face. I'm going to put a piece of blue tape across here and push it down nice and tight. Give all these outside surfaces a coat of this shellac. That's not shown in the plans, but I figured why not seal the rest of the pipe? It's certainly not going to hurt anything. Nobody will be able to see any of these. The only thing that's going to be visible on the organ will be the front covers. Before I put any shellac on here, I'm going to put an extra piece of wood on here, so when I drill the hole for my pipes, I'm going to put a piece of brass tube in there. The plans show drilling a hole in here and just sticking the pipe in there. You can do that, but this worked out pretty well on the tracker bars. I'm going to stick a length of pipe in there, put a little super glue on it, and that'll be good. All the pipes have been shellacked internally. All of these edges have been smooth. The insides have been smooth a little bit. Now we got to make the connection for the hoses on the back side of the pipe. Then I'll shellac the outside of the pipes, make the front covers. Then we have to do the tuning plugs and give each pipe a test tuning. There are tubes installed in all the pipes. This is a piece of 1/4-inch Baltic birch plywood. I drilled and countersunk it before I glued it on here. After it was glued on, I drilled a hole in the center of the air box from this side. This tube was cut to be 7/8 of an inch long and pressed in the hole until it's flush with the bottom of the air box. That leaves just over 1/2 inch sticking out, which is 2 hose diameters, so that should be sufficient. After these were done, I put enough super glue on there so it would wick all the way around that joint. And I suggest you go to your hobby shop and get a bottle of good quality thin super glue. I covered the front of the pipes to prevent shellac from getting on that surface. The pipes now have 2 external coats of shellac sanded in between coats. These are the mahogany strips cut to length for the front covers for one organ. For the front covers, I had 6 of these 2-inch wide, 2-foot long sheets of mahogany. They're 1/8 of an inch thick. After making the covers for the 34 pipes, I had 1 2-foot length left over, and this is a scrap. The covers turned out to be a pretty efficient cut material-wise. This is a piece of mahogany for the front cover of one of the pipes. Now this will be cut into 2 pieces. One part will cover the air box, and the other part is going to be tapered for the upper cover. I've drawn a line on this piece of masking tape so that I can get all of these about the same angle. You taper the end and then square it. Make sure you have an even edge. Check it on a square. Take an emery board, deburr that, and then that one's done. I want all of these tapers to be the same so it looks good on the front of the organ. That piece of masking tape on the disc sander helps achieve that. These are all a little bit longer than what is required. That will be in about that position when the pipe is tuned. I have this much extra to cut off to make the cover for the air box. And when these pipes are completed, all of these pipes are about 15% longer than what they need to be. So I can always come back and cut these off to the required length after everything is completed and tuned. I've already put these covers on the air box, and I had to sand the sides smooth and everything, so I had to wait until after this was glued on before I could put a finish on it. I'm using lacquer You want to be careful that you don't plug up this little slit here that the air comes out of. A little bit tedious, but you just plug away at it and you get it done. And this will have to be done twice. After this dries, I'll sand it down and then put a second coat on it. Pipes with the covers. The long covers have not yet been attached nor cut to length, and I still need to make the tuning plugs. I'm in the process of making tuning plugs for the pipes. I used a piece of Baltic birch plywood, 1/2 inch thick, and I sized that to where it just fits inside the pipe. These are shaker pegs. It has a 1/4 inch diameter by 1/4 inch long tenon on the end. Drilled a hole in there and glued those in. I now have a handle to hold onto. I can go up to the disc sander. I can sand these sides to where I have a clearance that's about the same as this piece of chamois. Cut that to where it'll just come up on the sides, either way. I sand that for the clearance, then I'm going to taper the 4 sides and see how it fits. It should slide in and out firmly, but not too tight. If you get it too tight, you'll make your wood split, and that will make you very unhappy. Take your time. The first couple of these, you don't want to make this plug sand it too small, or then you'll end up having to remake this whole piece. Just take your time and you'll get a feel for this, and it doesn't take too long after that. And when you're done, that plug should slide in and out of there very easily. I have not yet glued the chamois to the bottom of the tuning plug. I'm going to wait until after I get these tuned initially and see for sure how long the pipe needs to be, and get a finish on these shaker pins. And when you put this in for the final time, you want to put a little bit of talcum powder on that chamois, and that will act as a lubricant and make it easier to tune these. Slide that in and out. If the end of your pipe is not exactly square, then you sand your tuning plug equally not exactly square. It'll work out just fine. And the rough side or fluffy side of the chamois goes against the pipe, and the leather or a smooth side goes against the plug. All 17 tuning plugs are in place. Now I'm going to attach the front covers with rubber bands and give each pipe a test tuning. I played around tuning these, cut them off a little bit, This is still going to have to be cut off to the final length. I don't want to do that until I have the bellows and everything operating on the Senior 20, and I can test these with the air supply that's on the Oregon in which these will be installed. It's my intention to have these all cut off so the same amount of peg shows on each one, so there's still a bit that needs to be removed. These were built to be 15% longer than the dimension he gave. He recommends 10%. These are going to be very close to the dimensions that he gave by the time these are cut off to their final length. Now this is going to be on the front of the Senior 20, all 17 pipes, because I do not have a conductor. You need to keep in mind, if you're building an Oregon with the conductor, there's going to be 10 pipes in the front of the Oregon, which means you got another 7 pipes that have to disappear underneath the pressure box. And you will need some extra length to be able to cut these and miter them, to bend them around, get them to fit under that pressure box. I'm going to blow these pipes using the Busker air supply, and this is 5 inches of water instead of 6 or 8. I'm just going to move the hose from tube to tube each pipe. And the hose that I'm using is 2 foot long. On the Oregon itself, the hose will be relatively short, and the pipes will get better airflow and be louder as a result.